Praise God, praise God. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. I pray that you are having a blessed day in the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So let's get this third video underway. This title is The Children of Israel, The Return to Egypt. God says that he delivered us. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. And we're going right back into bondage. Bondage and working those jobs that God didn't tell you to have, no 2-3 jobs, because you're trying to keep up with the Joneses, or you want everybody to say that you're highly favored and blessed. Let me tell you something. If it is causing you stress, that can't be blessing. If it is causing you to miss time with your family, that can't be no blessing. If it is causing you your marriage, then that can't be no blessing. If it is causing you your health, that can't be no blessing. Somebody lying. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So let me go ahead and give you my verses for this. This is 2 Timothy chapter 3. God says, know this also, that in the last days perilous times shall come. For men should be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemies, disobedience to parents. We're seeing that more and more with the children, right? Unthankful, unholy, without natural affection. That's just what I just did. Homosexuality, truth breakers, false accusers, just lying on people, just lie to lie. Come on, somebody. Incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good. Verse 4, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than God. That's it right there. That's the thing God keeps telling me. Everybody wants to go on vacation. Everybody wants to just have fun. Nobody wants to labor anymore. You don't want to labor for your family. You don't want to labor for your brother. You don't want to labor for your sister. But let something happen. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Let something happen. You're going to be crying. Hallelujah to his name. And this was the word of God. Well, no, I want to do one more. Verse 5. Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. And that was the word of God. Let me tell you something. I'm seeing it more and more and more. And even people that I know that are close to me. And I preach, but I only move when God tells me to be moved. You are trading in the glory of God for money, the glory of God for jobs, the glory of God for sex, the glory of God for a platform, the glory of God for this, for that. Are you serious? Let me ask you something. You die today or tomorrow, where you going? Oh, come on, somebody, hallelujah. Who you repping for real? Quit playing. Because in front of people, we're trying to have this facade. We're trying to be this. We're trying to be that. But when you got to meet your maker on that day, what will you say, child of God? What will you say, man of God? What will you say, woman of God? Hallelujah. Well, God knew my heart. Yeah, he knows our heart. But that does not excuse you from the commandments. That does not excuse you from doing the right thing. That does not excuse you from putting it first. Matthew 6:33 says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness. Because we ain't right. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And then all shall be added until you. Y'all trying to put the cart before the buggy, so to speak. You want to do what you want to do. Oh, come on, somebody. I even have some close friends. You want to do what you want to do. But you see, when God, ta-ta. Oh, come on, somebody. Y'all know what the ta-ta is? If you don't know, keep living. Keep doing what you want to do, how you want to do it, when you want to do it. Hallelujah. And then when that thing happened, oh, come on, somebody. Let's go. I am reminded of Job. Job, was, they say, was the what? The wisest man. Come on, somebody. The most godliest man in the East. And what he feared the most came up on him. Do you want to know why? Because sometimes God will allow what you fear the most to come up on you. Sometimes God will allow things to break you down so you can see you. It's not about him knowing you. God knows you. He knew you was going to do what you did, how you did when you did it. But God wants you to know you. Some of you are trying to live for other people. Some of you are trying to live for status quo. Some of you want to be this and you want to be that. And you want accolades and you want this and you want that. When you going to want just God? Hallelujah. The return to Egypt. Everybody's after this. This was really plain. Oh, come on, somebody. Don't play with me. And the church feels like this. If you don't have it like that, then you're not blessed. Honey, I was blessed when I didn't have something. I was blessed when I didn't have no food. I was blessed when I didn't have no car. I was blessed when I didn't. Oh, when I didn't have. Hallelujah. The Bible says that the Son of Man had no place to lay his head. Why do you think so? Because all scripture is for our wisdom. Nothing just happens. God didn't just put that up in there just so that we'll have it. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So I pray in the name of Jesus that you understand what time it is and who we are and whose we are, because time ticking. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And the enemy makes you think that it's not. And the Bible says that even in the last day, they'll still be marrying, still be drinking, still be doing this, still be doing that. the return to Egypt. Come out of Egypt, says the Lord. Come out of Egypt, says the Lord. Get closer to your God in this hour. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Quit acting angry with your brother and sister. Some of you, you shouldn't even do nothing for people. Oh, I didn't say it. Some of you do stuff and you don't do it with a good heart. No, you don't. No, you don't. You do it with thinking, well, what I'm going to get in return. That is not of God, by the way. Hallelujah to his name. Hallelujah to his name. We have a church unchurched, like I said yesterday. The return to Egypt. God says that we're more in tune with the world than we are with his kingdom. When was the last time you really spent time with God? When was the last time you really cried unto the Lord? When was the last time you got your face on the altar before God? In your room, come on, somebody. The most powerful prayer of position is prostrate. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. When was the last time? When was the last time you went on a fast? When was the last time you surrendered to God? When was the last time that you worried about somebody else other than yourself? When was the last time, said the Lord? Hallelujah. The return to Egypt. God says that we have forgotten his name. We have forgotten his kingdom. More church folks are falling every day by the wayside. We're not spending time in the word. We're not spending time with God. We're not loving each other for real. We're not praying for each other for real. We're not laboring for each other for real. There's no more laboring. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And if it's inconvenience for you, you really ain't doing it. When was the last time? Because let me tell you something. It was not until Job prayed for his friends that he was released. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. It was not until Job prayed for his friends that he was released. And yes, honey, I forgot who you were that just said revival is coming. But repentance must take place first. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Don't get on no bandwagon because we love to get on that bandwagon. Revival coming, revival coming. Yes, revival coming. But repentance must come before revival. We gotta repent before God. God, I have sinned. Oh, God, please keep me. God, help me. Hallelujah. God, change me. God, help me get closer to you. Hallelujah. And don't let it be a facade, God. Let it be a real relationship. Hallelujah. Because in front of people we love to, you know, but it's behind closed doors in the secret place. That's where you get your power. Oh, come on, somebody. That's where you're getting your anointing. Come on, somebody. That's where you understand who is God. The return to Egypt. Stop putting that man before God. Stop putting that woman before God. Stop putting that church before God. Stop putting that job before God. Stop putting anything before God. Anyone that comes before God is your God. Hallelujah. And everybody talk about money now. More than God. Can I tell you something? God talks about money only 20 times in the Bible. Hallelujah. But he talks about being saved 200 times. Let's talk about that one. Do you understand what I'm saying? And those were rough figures. So I pray in the name of Jesus that you understand who I am and what I'm saying to you. I am your sister and I am trying to warn you. Hallelujah. Because God is coming. I'm telling you, God is coming. And he says, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Hallelujah to his name. So God bless you. God keep you. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. Roll out, soldiers, for that is who you are. God bless.